Hello guys, welcome to my channel Game Insider. So in today's class we are going to discuss about second topic or the topics of first chapter of class 11, that is some basic concepts of chemistry. So in that we are going to discuss about the properties of a substance. So every substance has certain number of categories or characteristics of itself, and those characteristics are also called properties, and these properties are classified into two types. One is a physical property, the other one is a chemical property. A substance which has a different type of property characteristics are classified one after the other in the sequential manner of its one of the properties. Either it may be physical property or it may be a chemical property. So what is this physical and chemical properties in general? So physical property is one where we have to observe a given substance and we have to know the particular property of its substance by just without changing its identity or not at all any changing its any configurations at all. So we don't have to change its configuration or its identity in order to know the property involved in the given substance, and those type of properties are called physical properties. So these physical properties might be said as, for examples, density, its odor, color, or the state it is present, the boiling point or the melting point of the given substance, etc. So these are all called the physical properties of a given substance. So in order to know a particular physical property of a substance, we don't have to change its composition at all. Like for example, if you have to change, know the density of a given substance, what you have to do is you should take the solution or a compound in a given specific weighing bottle. You need to find its volume, you need to find its mass. Once you divide with one another, you get the density. If you have to measure its melting point, you have to melt it in a particular process of a melting process, and you have to note down its melting point. Okay, so if any of the physical properties, if you have to check for a substance, you don't have to change the composition of the given substance. Either you have to convert it to a different component or a different component at all. So those type of properties are called physical properties. And these physical properties, we don't have to change its composition at all. And these physical properties can observe by our five sense organs as we use them. Next, for the chemical properties, what you have to do is, in order to know the particular given chemical property of a substance, what you have to do is you need to convert a given reactant, a substance, into certain different products. So if you have given an unknown substance, what you have to do is first you have to convert that unknown substance to a substance which you know, whose chemical properties are known to you. So if you are taking a certain substance, you need to change its chemical composition in such a way that it should change its composition to a product which is similar to your chemical propertical knowledge. Okay, so that type of properties are called chemical properties. Like for example, if you have to reduce a substance, you will take a reduction process. If you have to oxidize a substance, you will carry out oxidation process. So you need to consider carry out some certain process in order to know a substance chemical properties. So once you know either of this physical or chemical property, especially in case of the physical properties, you may give them a proper unit. If you say, let us say I need 1 kilogram of cloth, you won't usually say that, right? Or you can't say, you give me 1 kilogram of water. Or you cannot even say, give me 1 kilogram of temperature, right? So one particular quantity has its own particular units. Okay, so this concept of units came into existence in the early 16th and 17th century, and there were two metric systems used for giving a particular unit for a physical quantity. One was the English metric system, the other was a French metric system. Out of these two systems, certain countries used English metric system and certain other countries used French metric systems, which made other people get confused. Let us say Indians use English metric system and they have converted some measures of some values and they have sent them to a different country which uses a French metric system, and that country doesn't know English metric system. They get confused with the values and there will be confusion calculations at all. So therefore, the Union of Chemistry decided to make a particular one unit system which can be used all over the world. So in the 11th conference of General Conference of Weights and Measures, it was decided that all the world should use a single metric system of unit given measurement that was called as the SI system, that is International System of Units and Measures. So international system of units and measures, which we call them as SI units. Okay. So they discussed they classified all the physical properties under seven classes as a basic seven physical quantities. And those seven physical quantities are such as these seven. Those are length, mass, time, electric current, temperature, amount of substance and intensity. So this is how we classified all the physical properties into the seven basic components of physical quantity. Length, mass, time, electric current, temperature, amount of substance and intensity. We can also call this temperature as thermodynamical temperature and the intensity as luminous intensity also. So these were the seven basic physical quantities which were used to classify a given physical property. So the symbols for each of those physical quantities are, for length we give the symbol L and for mass we give the symbol M, time we have symbol T, electric current we have I and temperature of symbol is T, amount of substance is given by small m, whereas luminous intensity is given by IV. Don't get confused with electric current I and intensity IV. And each of these symbols or each of these physical quantity are given a specific SI unit. Those are meter for length, which has a symbol small m. Don't get confused with the SI unit symbol m with symbol of mass m. Okay. So this is for, if you have unit as m, that means it says meter. And for mass, we have unit kilogram given as kg, denoted as kg. Time we have second. Sometimes we also give time in the SI unit of units of minutes, hours, years, etc. But what you have to specifically use is second in order to give a SI unit for time. Next, for current we have amperes denoted by the symbol capital A. And for the temperature we have symbol Kelvin. In India we use degrees Celsius and all the other countries we use Kelvins. And then we have amount of substance, that is N in moles, M-O-L-E, which is having a symbol of M-O-L, which is denoted by M-O-L. And then we have intensity as candela, which is denoted by the symbol, the SI unit symbol as CD. So these are the seven basic physical quantities and their respective symbols, name of the SI units and symbol of the respective SI units. So these are the seven basic physical quantities and their respective SI units which we use. Next we are going to discuss about is definition of SI unit. So what is the definition of the SI unit meter? So the SI unit meter is for the physical quantity of length. So you usually measure cloths or distance with respect to our SI unit of meter. So how does meter come into existence for its definition? We need to use the sunlight passing, have a speed of sunlight. So what do we know is speed of light is in vacuum. Speed of light in vacuum is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. This is what we know, 3 into 10 to the power 8 meters per second, right? So this is the speed of light which I have discussed in our 10th grade or 9th grade. So the time, the distance traveled by light in vacuum for 1 by 3 into 10 to the power 8 times the path covered or the distance traveled by a light in vacuum for 1 by 3 into 10 to the power 8 part is called a meter. So the distance meter, the SI unit meter is defined as the path covered by light of sun in vacuum for 1 by 3 into 10 to the power 8 times the second. Okay. So for 1 second of 1 by 3 into 10 to the power 8 times of the second, the distance traveled. So if we are considering the speed of light in this direction, so if you cut 1 by 3 into 10 to the power 8 times, so if you are dividing 1 second by 3 into 10 to the power 8 times, the one part of that particular second on that particular part, that using that particular time limit, the light traveling some distance, let us say this is the distance, so that distance will be called 1 meter. So meter, that is an SI unit of length, is defined as the path traveled by light in vacuum for one part of a 1 divided by 3 into 10 to the power 8 times of a second. Okay, so if you divide 1 second, 1 second by 3 into 10 power 8, we get a small minute part of time. At that particular point of time, if light travels at a certain distance, that distance is said to be 1 meter. Okay, so if I say light travels from this point to this point in one part of 1 by 3 into 10 power 8 times of a second, then that distance from one point to the other point, one point to the other point, is called a meter. Okay, so meter is defined as the path covered by light in vacuum for period of 1 by 3 into 10 power 8 times of a second. Okay, so that is a meter definition. So definition of meter. Okay, next is definition for kilogram. We actually don't have a particular definition for kilogram. That is because in the SI unit system, we use a prototype. A prototype is like something we use for configuration, like we use just for a comparison of masses. So we have an exact 1 kilogram mass present in our SI unit system of chambers. So we use that particular unit as a comparison of our normal kilogram measurement devices. Okay, so we don't have a particular specific definition for kilograms. Next is definition for time. So what is the definition of time? So time is, or the second, is defined as the duration taken. For definition of time, we need to consider a molecule or an atom of cesium. In order to define second, what we have to consider is an atom of cesium-133. Cesium-133 atom has very fine lines in its ground state. So let us say these are the two very fine lines of the ground state of cesium-133 atom. If the radiation present in the ground state between the two lines take one jump from one level to the other level, so the transition of one level to the other level takes certain amount of time. So that time in specific is called second. A second is defined as the number of periods taken by radiation of two fine lines present in cesium-133 atom's ground state for a complete transmission. So if a radiation present in the ground state of cesium-133 atom takes a transition between its two fine lines at a particular given period, if the radiation present in the fine ground state of cesium-133 atom for a particular given period of time from one level to the other level, then that period of time is called a second. That is, 1 second is defined as the time period of radiation, time period taken by the radiation for a transmission from ground states of two fine lines of cesium-133 atom. So that is found to be 19192630770. So this is the duration of 1 split second radiation transmission between one level to other level. So this is about the definition of second. Next, for the definition of electric current, that is ampere. So next, for the definition of ampere, denoted by a symbol A. For the definition of ampere, we need to consider a system of conductors. So let us say we are placing two very fine conductors of infinite length, such as like this, whose cross section is very, very negligible, and they are of infinite length and are very parallel to one another. So once they are connected to an external circuit, the current flowing between two conductors with negligible cross section of infinite length, which are taken in a vacuum and separated by a distance of 1 meter, exact 1 meter distance, if two conductors of infinite length and very negligible cross sections are placed 1 meter apart from each other in vacuum, then the current generated between those two conductors is said as 1 ampere. So, an ampere of a current is said to be the current generated by two conductors which are in parallel to one another, which are parallel to one another and they have infinite length and very negligible cross section, and those two have to be taken in vacuum and should be placed 1 meter apart from one another. Then the current generated or flowing through those conductors is called 1 ampere. So this is the definition of 1 ampere. Next, for the definition of temperature, that is Kelvin. So definition of Kelvin. Kelvin K. For the definition of Kelvin, what we consider the Kelvin as, it is equal to 1 by 273.16 times 1 by 273.16 times the temperature of triple point of water. Triple point of water. It is 1 by 273.16 times the temperature of triple point of water. A Kelvin is equal to 1 by 273.16 times of the thermodynamic temperature of a triple point of water. So the definition of Kelvin is, it is 1 by 273.16 times the thermodynamic temperature of a triple point of water. So that is what the definition of Kelvin says. Next, for the definition of mole, so that is amount of substance present. For the amount of substance present, we use mole, which is in configuration with respect to our carbon 12 isotope. We use our carbon 12 isotope in order to define the number of substance present. So what do we define, what do we say for the number of moles? A substance is said to be having one mole of amount of substances if it carries same amount of substances found to be present. The amount of substances, one mole of substance is said as the amount of substance equal to 0.012 kilograms of C12 isotope. So if a substance has same mass as that of 0.012 kilograms of C12 isotope, and it is said to be as one mole. So that is, carbon 12 isotope of 0.012 kilogram carries 12 atoms of carbon. So if you have to say one mole of a substance, that means it should have mass equal to 0.012 kilograms of carbon 12 isotope. Then that particular amount of substance is said to be one mole. Okay, a one mole of a substance is nothing but the amount of substance which is equal to the 0.012 kilograms of carbon 12 isotope. So it is equal to 0.012 kilograms of carbon 12 isotopes particles present. The amount of particles present in carbon 12 isotopes, 0.012 kilograms. If that is the amount of number of substances present in a given substance, then that amount of substance is said to be one mole. So this is about the definition of one mole. Next, for definition of intensity, that is candela. So now the last one we need to define is the intensity SI unit, that is candela. So a candela is a SI unit for intensity. Candela is a SI unit of intensity, or that is especially luminous intensity. For this, let us consider a source such as like this. So if this source S, emits radiation of a frequency, if this is emitting the radiations of certain frequency, and if that certain frequency is equal to 540 into 10 power 12 hertz, if a source emits radiations of frequency 540 into 10 to the power 12 hertz, and it also has a radiant frequency of 1 by 683 watts per stadium, then that source is said to emit one candela. If a source of light is emitting radiations of frequency 540 into 10 to the power 12 hertz and also has a radial intensity, so this is our radiant intensity, not the lumens. If it has a radiant intensity of 163 watt per steradian, then that source is said to be emitting one candela of luminous intensity. So how do we define a candela of luminous intensity? A candela of luminous intensity is said to be emitted by a source if that source is emitting a radiation at 540 into 10 to the power 12 hertz, and further it should have 1 by 683 watt per steradian of radiant intensity. Then that emitted light is said to be is of one candela. Okay, so this is about the definition of SI units. I hope you have understood about the different basic physical quantities of our SI system and the definition of this SI units: meters, time, mass. We don't have a specific definition for mass. Meter, time, and then we have temperature, and we have our luminosity, current, and mole. Okay, so if you like this video, please do subscribe to my channel, share this among your friends in order to get them use of this, and please do comment if you have any doubt, and you can also clear your doubts through a mail. I have provided my email address on the description box. Thank you for watching.